Hi everyone, welcome or welcome back to the channel. It's the Poodle Mom again with the two toy poodles. So, are you bringing home your very first puppy or your new furry family member? Are you worried about what things to prepare or buy for them before they arrive in your home? Then, this video is for you. In this video, we will be sharing with you our top things to buy or to prepare for your new pup before they arrive. If you guys are interested in that, then please keep on watching. If you will like the video, don't forget to give it a thumbs up and maybe share the video. It would really help the channel. Alright, let's get to it. So for the first one, dog food. You cannot have a dog without dog food. It's best to feed whatever it is that your breeder is currently feeding your pup. Usually the breeders will provide a small portion so that you can bring it home with you. After they finally adjust to your home, that's when you transition them from their old puppy food to the new puppy food that you want to feed them. For the girls, I only transitioned them to home cooked when they turned 1 year old, but that's only because I didn't know about it. But had I known about raw and home cooked meals back then, I would have transitioned them earlier. But nonetheless, I would buy the puppy food so that they will adjust accordingly to their new. For the second one would be vitamins and supplements. Now, if you're feeding dog food, it's commonly known that it is already completely balanced, but it never hurts to give vitamins to puppies. Now, I would recommend getting the same supplements that your breeders are currently feeding the pups because much like the dog food, it's best that they transition later on once they've already adjusted to your new home. If you guys were curious as to which brands that I used for my dogs, I use NHV for the two girls. I absolutely love the multi-essentials and the turmeric of NHV. I also currently use, it's called the Augustine Approved Super Boost and Faith. They're also safe for puppies, so if you guys are interested, there will be affiliate links in the description box below. So for the third one would be your pet feeding bowls and pet drinking bowls. Now, I know there are a lot of options in the market. There's plastic, and then there's ceramic, and then of course stainless steel. But if you will ask me for food and for water, I would choose to go with stainless steel. From what I've learned is that out of the three, stainless steel retains the least amount of bacteria prior and after cleaning. So I think it's safest for your pets. The one that I'm currently using from a brand called Fuzzyard. I got this from the Pet Expo in Singapore. I've had this for 4 years. I use it every day. It's always in water and everything, but there's no sign of rusting and it's still as good as new. For the pet drinking bowls, you can use the same one, but one thing to note about poodles is that they're not exactly very enthusiastic about drinking. That's when I learned about getting them a water fountain. So it's best to get another stainless steel, but the thing is, pet water fountains are not exactly very common as of yet. Slowly, they are becoming more common. They're usually used for cats, but there are options for dogs as well. And since they are small dogs, the ones for cats would also work for them. My next puppy essential is, of course, a crate. Now, there are many options of crates. There's the steel crate, and then there are foldable ones, and then the travel crates. Personally, I use the travel crates because I wanted it only for purposes of training. Because I want them to be ready anytime I want to be able to travel with them, then they're comfortable in the travel crate already. Two, I didn't want too much clutter in my house. So if I would have to buy a steel crate plus the travel crate, then in my head, where am I gonna store that in my really, really tiny room? But of course, you can use the steel crates in whatever crate you have. Most trainers will recommend the steel crates, and it's really up to you. I just prefer the travel crates. Next one would be collars and leashes. Now, this is one of my most favorite accessories in dogs, and I am guilty of buying a lot of different kinds of collars and leashes for them. You have so many choices. There are the rope leashes, there's the nylon, and then the beautiful leather leashes, etc. For puppies, what I would recommend is actually just getting a super cheap collar in the beginning because they will outgrow the collars later on. Plus, they tend to chew on them. So if you buy a super expensive collar, if they chew on it, then that's bye-bye cash. I've gone over the crazy shopping state. So now I actually just have one kind of leash. So I just currently use what you call a slip leash. I no longer put collars on them. I do put them when they go outside just so that they have their tags with them. The thing is with collars for poodles, if you leave them 24/7, like you don't remove them, they tend to cause mats on their fur, which is a lot of trouble for me. So what I like with a slip-on leash is that you don't need the collars anymore.
So this is how it looks like. It's one whole thing. And there's a hook that you can slide in and out so that you can adjust it to the neck of your dog. And then you just slide it back in once you have the right size so that it doesn't slip off.
So you basically just slide it in and then you just lock it. And then that's it. So we go for walks using this. I still have my favorite leather leashes, of course. But for daily walks and everything, this is all I use. Because I just find it so convenient that I don't have to put so many things on them and then I just have this. Plus, yeah, I hate the matting because if you guys will notice, most of our videos are on grooming because I am particular with clean dogs. Mostly because my family is not a big fan of dogs. So my girls have to look their best all the time and they have to smell their best. So the next one for me would be training treats. Now this for some people is not an essential, but for me it is because I am particular with training my dogs. Of course, you're gonna have to have a set of treats that you will be giving them when you train them for positive reinforcement. There are a lot of brands that you can find in your own home countries and of course in the Philippines. It's really up to you. This is just my preference. So for the girls, I have been using Pothic Plate. They have a wide variety of different treats. I only give meaty treats. I do also give some fruits and stuff. Pothic Plate also has them. And we have been feeding the girls this brand since, how long has it been, babe? 4-5 years? And they have done well with them. I'll also put links in the description box below if you guys are interested in their products. I use these for training and for the picky eaters. It helps sometimes to put something new on their food. For the treats, I would recommend that you choose an all-natural brand, no matter what it is. It could be biscuits and stuff. Just make sure the ingredients, there are very few. Before, I thought Summer had allergies to chicken, but when I started giving her pure chicken, she apparently wasn't allergic to the actual chicken. It might be some other ingredient that's included in the treat or in the food that I was giving her that was causing the allergies, but I just generalized it as chicken. For the next one would be a clicker. If you want to train your dog with positive reinforcement, the clicker will very much help. So I just basically use this to mark a good behavior for my dogs. One thing to note when you're buying a clicker is that you buy one that has an option to change the loudness of the clicker. Also, you don't want the clickers that bulges out because you usually just keep them in your pocket because dogs, they easily read your subtle movements. Holding it is fine, but eventually, for example, for really, really smart dogs like poodles, the minute you hold the clicker, they would know when you're gonna click or not. So I usually hide it in a bag behind me so that they don't know when I click or not. Next would be natural cleaning sprays. There are a lot of options now online for these cleaning sprays. So I have been using this brand called Fetch. It's another local brand and I personally know the owner and I absolutely love this because I practically use this for cleaning everything. You can't have a dog without a cleaning spray. You need them. And what I love about it is that they're even safe for babies. So, you know, pretty much they're safe for dogs. They can lick it and it's non-toxic. Next would be shampoos. I have two brands that I actually stick with right now. So of course, there's also, Fetch also has their own shampoo for dogs. I personally love the Neem shampoo because it's anti-tick and flea and the coats of my girls do well on this along with the other brand that I use, which is called the Chris Christensen for the color maintenance shampoo. They also have a lot of shampoo varieties. I've tried the day-to-day shampoo as well as the conditioner and the Spectrum one, that's for poodles because they have different kinds of shampoo based on the coats of your dog. You can contact them. There is a local distributor here in the Philippines and there are affiliate links also for their Amazon store for those who are from other countries like the US and Canada. For the next one, you cannot have poodles without the proper grooming tools because poodles are high maintenance when it comes to grooming. My go-to brands are, of course, Chris Christensen. You know, ever since I've tried this brand for the brushes, I have never even looked back. Like there was one that I bought in Singapore, which was really, really, really nice. But when I was using it, it was still nothing compared to the Chris Christensen Slicker Brush. So this is my go-to brush since 2014, 2015. And I've only changed it once, just last year when I flew to the States. But this one from Chris Christensen also is a stainless steel butter comb. It's the 004, if I'm not mistaken. It's for poodles. I bought this since 2014 and I haven't changed it since then. It's still as good as new. And of course, there's the pin brush from Madame. This one is not too expensive. I did try the Chris Christensen pin brush, but in my experience, I prefer the Madame pin brush. So next would be the sprays, of course, the dematting and the grooming sprays. This is my go-to dematting spray. You can never go wrong with Chris Christensen's Ice on Ice. I use Pure Paws' H2O Hydrating Mist. I like the fragrance of this one, so I use this as my finishing spray that I pair up with the Chris Christensen. Or when I get lazy, my latest find from NHV, the NHV's Cocoa Fur Care. This is my travel grooming spray because it's an all-in-one. It acts as both my Chris Christensen and Pure Paws, plus it wards off ticks and fleas. So before I would buy a different brand for the anti-tick and flea, but ever since I found this, this is my go-to for sure. An all-in-one, less clutter, that's a win for me. Next would be nail clippers. Now, I know that most, if not all of you, will be taking your dogs to the vet or maybe the groomers to do the nail clipping for you, but it still never hurts to train your pup as soon as they get home to desensitize them from the grooming tools so that when you take them to the groomer, then it won't be too much of a problem for the groomers when they do it, and it won't be a traumatizing experience for the dog. These are regular grooming scissors for their nails. And then I also bought I think it's called a nail Dremel or something. It basically is a nail file that's electric, and I love it because I don't know if you guys can hear that, but it's not noisy, and you know, the girls are totally fine with me using this. There's no brand, so I don't know. I'll show you the model. I don't know if that helps. So I just bought this online as well. I will check my email history where I bought it, and then I'll put a screenshot if I can find it here in this video as well. So next, of course, is a good microfiber towel for grooming. So when I bought it, it comes in a pair. So there's a small towel like this, and then there's a bigger towel that's for the regular human sized towel. I got it from Singapore from a brand called, I hope I pronounce it correctly, Woofer and Perlinski. I absolutely love the owner. If you go to her store, she's the one who personally sells her products. And I know there are a lot of microfiber towel options out there, but I was recommended this towel by another friend and I bought one first. And ever since then, I've never used another microfiber towel besides hers. A good microfiber towel will really speed up your grooming. And I have mentioned that in a lot of our grooming videos, which I will be linking up occasionally in the cards above as well as in the description box below if you guys are interested in watching it after this video. Number 14 would be wee pads. It's really up to you, whatever brand you find. For me, I think the last one that I purchased was from SNR. It's like Target here in the Philippines. The brand is Kirkland, if I'm not mistaken, and it comes like in this giant box that is around 100 pieces, if I'm not mistaken. For the last one would be a good dog bed. I have used many brands, but I have stuck by this local brand called Bauhaus, and I personally love the Snorbox. What I loved about it is that the covers are easily changed, so you can wash the covers, everything. There's a zipper over here, and you can remove these pillows. They sell replacement covers. Now, this brand is quite expensive. That's one thing to note. Since you can wash these, the beds don't smell. If you are with a family that has a lot of allergies, as well as, you know, not exactly super dog lovers like yourself, having products like these will really help in keeping your house dog smell free. I don't know if that makes sense, but... So I made this list actually with a concept in mind of being like a pet minimalist, because again, I have gone through that phase already wherein you kept buying and buying and buying a lot of stuff, and then there's just too much clutter, and more often than not you don't even use all those things. But in my opinion, these things that I have listed down are things that you will be using all throughout their lives. So that's it. We hope you enjoyed the video and maybe learned something from it. Feel free to comment down below your thoughts and maybe share with us your ideas and maybe things that you think could be added to the list. I would be very much interested because it could be something that I can learn from as well in case I have a new puppy in the future. So that's it. Thank you guys so much for watching. Thank you for subscribing, and we will see you again next time. Bye.
Yeah, I know it's your bed. I'm not gonna steal it from here.
Then you just slide it in.